as you would expect. When you refer to that person, yeah. Who is that person indeed? Uh-oh. That sounds like the elevator. Or maybe not. What's going on? Are we done with the stage? No, we are not done with the stage. That was just a mid-boss. As you would expect. So, we are going underground, and we are most likely going to be dealing with it overall, I guess. That's the one that Remilia definitely does not want to deal with. Okay, Satori, you have telepathy now, sure, why not? Let's roll with it. Stop following me. That's not very nice. Yep. Got stand in the land scorched by hell itself. Oh man. Yeah. Tip and close, okay. This is not my favorite music out of Subterranean Animism. It's definitely like that's Heartfelt Fantasy or Lullaby, but this is a really, really nice rendition of what was it called again? Is it Hellfire Mantle or something? I forget what it was called, but it's the Stage 6 theme. So rude. Take some time to get out. Other beings fell in as well, huh? Blasted fairies. Alright. Yeah, let's go deal with it. Do not forget to... Oh my gosh. Alright. Fair enough. Yes, you will. Also, Satori's picture is now like fully dinged up. That's okay. Yep, Satori does still read minds and is still a jerk like that. Alright, so we have to do some errands for the underground, huh? That's not really what I was expecting, but whatever. Useless room transition is useless. I didn't expect the stage to be that short, so I'm kind of glad that it is not that short. We can not jump off here as you'd expect. This is really, really nice looking. Also, the heat shimmer is a really cool effect here, actually. Definitely well worth looking into. This actually reminds me a little bit, structure-wise, of... I think it was stage 4, actually, in the previous game. No, it wasn't stage 4, it was stage 5? I want to say, it was the one... No, it would have been stage 4, it's the factory place, where it was sort of in a room transition. But at the same time, it's kind of got the stage 3 aspect of being with a mid-boss. Like, Momiji was the mid-boss for stage 3 in the previous game. And Aya was the main boss, and here we have the three fairies as the mid-boss, and probably Auron, I want to say, would be the main boss here. So, yeah, that's it's kind of interesting. Also, the enemies have not leveled up this time, so that's also potentially interesting to note. I did, of course, see the gold chest at the top before, so that's where we are going to go now. Again, plenty of equipment here, which is good for considering my drop rate's kind of low. That wasn't a gold chest at all. It just looked gold before because of the heat shimmer. At least to me, anyway. It probably didn't on the video, but whatever. Does not matter. Are we going to get heals? No. Oh, so this is just like room by room? Oh, this is even more interesting then, because I guess this place might be pretty difficult to render, huh? You can't go over that, so I guess we're going to be going around the long way, which is fine. Oh, I didn't actually kill you, okay. Or there was just a second one. Probably just a second one. So we have doorways that we can go through, and crows that all just get wrecked by vampire spin, because it is OP. Is this going to take us around? No, this just doesn't take us anywhere. Boring! Why are the mushrooms growing this far underground? That doesn't make any sense to me, but whatever. Is there anything over here? No, it is just staying. I don't necessarily want to go in that door. Why did I open those? Why is there a shrine thing down here? So many questions. I guess I will go in that other door then, see where that goes. Yeah, when you're going downhill, the demon arrow thing is really, really good. This looks like a Colosseum Tyrus. There's a... Oh, that's a new enemy. Whoa, that is a new enemy indeed. And you can charge forward as well. Good for you, mister. You're still going to get broken. The enemies here are a level higher than they were before, so they are going to still level up a little bit. Okay. That's interesting. So, we have another one of those fairies to take care of. If you can snipe them before they start attacking you, that's fine. So really, this was just an introduction to the wheel carts that Orin uses. So that's interesting. Also, the everything respawn. Okay, so when you do a room transition, all of the stuff reappears. Okay, that's good to know. That includes the healing and stuff like that. So you can still not jump off of this. It's a maze-like structure. Okay. Well, you can just get sniped from a distance because I don't care to deal. Oh. What? Wait. You can fall off of some bits of this, but not what? Okay. That I did not expect. All right. So there's another death to chalk up to stuff, I suppose. But yeah, you can apparently jump off of the edge of this stuff, so that's great. Wish I'd have known that beforehand, because that would have made this a much different affair, actually. This is definitely way different to what I was expecting this to be, because of the fact that you can run off the edges here. I am terrible at trying to get this thing aimed, by the way. Just in case there was ever any doubts at that, I am really, really bad at aiming the heartbreak. Okay, this is going to get annoying because really, really thin passageways and the ability to die at like any point just from accidentally going too far across is not... I don't know, I mean, it's not bad, it's just it's going to be a pain to deal with at times, I think. That's all I need to say on the subject. So I guess, are you expected to jump over the stuff here? You're probably not expected to have to glide over stuff, but it is definitely a valid option. There is a heal down here. I obviously don't need it because I just died recently. Yeah, this is a weird area. And I guess we are looking for you guys, huh? As we knew, but they're going to be one at a time, yeah. Here to save you. Yeah, kind of are. And do we get taken? We get taken back to the entrance of the place. That is rather generous. Okay, so I'm assuming we're going to have three of these, and we have to just deal with that as it comes. Okay, that's cool. Oh, wow, you just don't care at all, do you? You just kind of charge on right in. Well, you know what? Whatever that's going to get you, that's going to get you snapped. By my spamming of the heartbreak, which is still not enough to kill you, because I'm really, really, really bad at aiming. It's fine. Cancel that stuff. Knock you out. It's not too big a deal because there are plenty of heals around, and as I've said before, heals do a lot of HP that way. So I don't even have to go into these. I just know one of them's probably going to have a chest. That was not very nice. Freaking things are trying to ambush me there. Rude. What have we got? We got anything in here? This is a different one. Okay. There's a sign. What does that sign say? Abandon all hope, ye who enter here. Okay. Right, we'll come back to that. Let's not abandon our hope just yet. more pink skirts, not really too big a deal. Is there anything beyond in here? No, I'm waiting for one of these to be like a way back to the very beginning. It would be kind of nice, because I know there was that one bit near the beginning. Oh! Wait a second, this is some, if this is right back at the start, this is some really weird, optical illusion style stuff there. Is this really back at the start? Now I'm getting confused, because this doesn't look like anything that I would be expecting. Yeah, I'm kind of lost at this point. So, we can jump off. That is a very important thing to note. We can jump off. I always have to check that stuff now, because we've had so many times when we've just been able to run to the edge of platforms and stuff, and it's been fine. But now we can actually jump off if we are not careful. So I do have to be more cautious about my platforming there. I have no idea where exactly I want to go now. I can return up this way, so that's fine. If it doesn't turn out to be, like, I want to go down in that abandon all hope path, but at the same time I kind of feel like that's probably going to be the end of the, like, either it's gonna just kill me or it's gonna be the end of a section, and I really don't know how much I want to deal with that. There's a chest over here I need to get, pick that up. Another battle skirt, probably gonna be useless then, since the queen cap seemed to be superior in absolutely everything. Which is fine. What else have we got? I think this is just it. There's how is Remilia surviving in here, by the way? Like, I'm pretty sure that sunscreen does not protect her from lava, you know? Oh, the intense glare of that. I don't understand how Remilia is still alive right now. But then again, Remilia is Remilia, so she's probably surviving because she's Remilia. Let's not get ourselves killed incessantly with that. I'm mostly just seeing, because there's no map and stuff around here, I'm trying just to see if there is other stuff around that I can deal with. Or not even deal with, but if there's other stuff around that I need to find. Basically just doing my usual explorey stuff. Doesn't really look like there's too much else that's different here, though. There's the lullaby! There we go. Nice that they've added that into the song as well. I didn't really think of, I didn't really notice it before, but I wasn't really looking for it, I guess, so. Another pink skirt, probably not too important. I see there's a lot of health and stuff around this area, which is interesting. Not really anywhere else to go here. Oh, that's neat. I mean, you can just jump straight over it, so it's not a big deal, but that's neat. We're probably gonna have that to deal with at some point. Huh. Also, I'd imagine they don't one-shot you, given that there's a lot of healing pots and stuff around there. Okay. These guys don't really look like upgrades to stuff, but I could totally see these being like upgraded millipedes or whatever, the new attacks and whatnot, but it doesn't look like they are. Let's just vampire spin our way through everything, and we'll take some hits, but not enough that I'm actually scared, so yeah. It's whatever, because there's plenty of potential for healing pots like that that I don't really need to worry too much about my own health, which is a very sad thing to say in a game like this. Also, a full heal there, and a chest that I did not reach. Take a chance? Haha, yes, nice, okay. Murasame, okay, that might actually be useful, and that's probably a sell item. So I was supposed to go round, but Remilia is pretty good at actually gliding and stuff. Okay, I guess we're not entering the Abandon All Hope section, so let's just see what we have as our items here. We have significantly worse, and yeah, unfortunately a lot worse. Fingernail named after a famous sword. Okay, so it's not actually there. Was it Murasame or yeah, it was Murasame. I keep forgetting, like, Muramasa and stuff like that. It's a different thing entirely. Okay, right, what else have we got? Anything of use? Probably not. Nope. What about the diamonds? Because we did get quite a few of those, so... Yep, that's strictly better than what we had. That's the same, that's better, that's better. That's the best one, so we'll go with that. And then, yeah, this is just for selling, so... Not really anything too important there. So, we need to go around this way and not get ourselves killed in the process, if I can help it. I guess we're not going to go to the Abandon All Hope part? Do I or don't I? No, I think... I really want to. You know, I really want to, but I guess we're just going to go up. Because that's where we're at now. We're at a weird sort of platformy type segment. That's not really much of a platformy segment, but you know. There's a mushroom in a weird spot there though, so we'll just snipe that down. Still on the lookout for hidden stuff. That's really why I'm kind of going along like this. And we'll pick up a diamond. We can actually go up this way, maybe, can we? No. Cocktails. Yeah, we can't go that way, so that's fine. We'll just go along and platform down here. Actually, there's an item to get to, which is fine. Even if I can't use them, I can obviously sell them, so still worth having these pink skirts and stuff like that. There's nothing over here, so that's whatever. Can I snipe you? Yes, I can. And you also drop another pink skirt. Whatever. Any point in going down here? Probably not, but we'll just take these guys out just to make sure they don't become an issue later. That's just going back down to where we were, that we can't go back up from there, so no point going that way. Can I snipe you from here? Yes, if I jump. So, verticality being a little bit of a thing, I can't go up that way from there, but I can from here. There was an arrow going the other direction, so of course we're going to go this way first. See that there was absolutely nothing! Oh man. That's fine, it's not the end of the world. So, with Satori saying that her pet that's forgetful. That is making me think that it is actually Utsuha that we're going to be seeing here. Alright, where are we now? Where are we now? We are in a separate area. So, I don't know how much I like this. I am completely and utterly lost now. Yeah, I have no idea exactly where we are within the stage at this point, and that's not necessarily a good thing. Is this another... oh, this has got, like, lots and lots of enemy stuff here. Wow, okay. I know what the goal of our expedition here is. I just don't know, like, where I'm going. That's kind of a bad thing, I suppose. Vampire... turn is still, like, and spin is still really good. Is this just a... Yeah, we can't break that. That's fine. Nothing else in here, so really just enemies. You could grind off of these rooms because the enemies respawn, but obviously I don't need to grind at the moment. I guess this is our second quote-unquote challenge room? What have we got this time, then? Have we got... more... ooh, okay. Moving block stuff that would kill us that way. Right, that's cool. I wonder if we could have gotten on top of those. That would have been interesting. Yeah, platforming! That's, also... weird stuff that way. Do these fall? I get the feeling these should fall, but I guess they don't? No, they don't. Can you break these? No. Wow, this is going to be a really, really long stage, isn't it? Oh, well, I could get on top of this one. Does that do anything for me? I don't think so, because this is solid. Yeah, you can notice here that I don't stay on the platform when the platform moves vertically, like the box. So I am actually in a falling animation at that point, which is interesting to deal with. Yeah, these are just solid block stuff, so nothing too fancy there. That's okay. Alright, Star, you're here with us now. There's nothing beyond you, so see you here. Yep. Tell you about it later, just come with us. Okay, so that's fine. Just had to kind of stretch a bit there. This, once again, is going on a fair bit longer than I would have expected. Can you, you can't go through that, so that's a bit disappointing. But I suppose it's better than having all of the room, all of the things having just dead ends and stuff. What is in this combat room? We have, a lot of nasty stuff. That's fine. Vampire turn is pretty good. It's not even turn, it's spin, but it's pretty good. And that helps us out a lot there. There's another pink skirt. Not really going to be using that ever, but it's fine. Just casually avoid you and spam you with all the stuff. And yeah, I could have taken no damage there if I'd have just used more heartbreaks, but I do not need to use more heartbreaks. My heart is broken enough already. Whoa. Alright, what else we got? Nothing in there, and I suppose that is fine. There's a gold chest there, though, which is potentially pretty good. Get away from me, Mr. Crow. Talon of the Devil is useless, unfortunately, so that is fine. What is in this combat room? More of the same? More of the same, except this time it's with a secondary feature of being able to snipe everything from a distance with heartbreaks. Not that we can do that anyway, but, you know. Yeah, not really too much of a challenge room in this one. Left a fairy behind, though. You never leave fairies behind. You must murder all of them, because they sometimes give you goodies that you could sell at a later date. Please don't do that in real life if you see a fairy, however. That would not be very nice. Ow, you piece of... I knew you were coming, and I just didn't get my attack off in time. Because you're a jerk. Alright, so this will be where Sunny is, then. And we shall finish off stuff. You cannot jump off of the side of this. So, yeah, a little bit of inconsistency with that, but that is fine. Honestly, it seems like Luna's path has been the most difficult so far. Yeah, although this does have rotating blades. So I guess you could kind of count that as tricky? This looks really neat, though. Gotta say, that looks impressive. I wonder if you, like, the abandoned or hope bit is just that you had to... Why are there so many here? I should not have opened up all of those. Okay, so here we have to go around the bull. Oh! Oh, that's not what I expected. I expected to be able to go under that, but no, we just have to jump all of them. Okay, that's fine. It's not too difficult, but I wasn't expecting that. That's a point of no return, so I don't want to go there just yet. Now we actually have to go on top of this block if we want to not get ourselves caught like that. I got caught out by the whole jumping thing. Like I mentioned before, you do not have, you do not stay on the block whilst it's moving up and down. So this is what I was after. I was after an item, and I messed it up because, yeah. It's a bit of an annoyance, actually, when you're trying to do precision, like, platforming stuff, and you can't... It's not even that precise, but... Ooh. Yeah, it's awkward when your platform does not keep you moving. Stuff! Why did I... They just don't do that much damage, though. You see, like, even with this, they are still only doing 60-something damage. It's, like, I have 1300 health. 60 damage is not going to be enough to really mess me up. I don't know, like, I feel like these should be doing 200 or 300 damage, not, right, okay, so if you are there, then that means... Oh, well, I suppose they can chain hits pretty well. Maybe that's what the real challenge here is. That's what I was after, getting an item. Can I just jump over to that bit? Yes, I can. Okay, and that is all... You are a jerk! Alright, so I got knocked away by that there. That's a real danger, I guess, huh? We're still gonna go this way around, mind you. Because it's not that bad, I just, I got caught unawares because I am good at video games, man. Why are we here? What are we planning? We're just, yeah. No, really don't. Let's go and, deal with stuff. Right, so, we have everyone here. Why would you do that? Because we need, answers. But we need to find Stoa. Alright, telepathic Satori. Go meet up, blah, 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 blah. Is this where the abandoned all hope thing should come back? Because that's the only thing we really have left now. Is that. And if, oh no, we can go up. I have no idea what the abandoned all hope thing is then. I really want to find out. But, I don't know. Do I go back? I think it's possible. Ah, let's go find out. It's probably just going to be a kill thing, but let's go find out.
Because I'm feeling that way, but I guess... Was it this way that we went back? No. Alright, I guess I will probably cut stuff until we get there then. So, yeah, let's have some fun.
Alright, here we are. Can we go in? Oh, we can. I'm still walking. Can I jump off? I can't jump off the edge? Or can I? I'm walking on like nothing there. Amulet, another amulet of certain victory. Okay, we are actually going to check this because... whoa, that's a lot of crit chance. It would cut my skill points back down to 8, but... 30% crit is definitely... Aw, oh man, so that's all it... Well, I'm glad that in a way that's all it is. But yes, you can fall off it. And it will kill you for doing so. But that just gets us back up, so... Okay, that was worth it. I'm not quite sure why it let me walk so far off the edge there, but... Okay, I'm okay with this now. Now that I know what went down. So, yeah, let's meet you guys back where the stage continues. Okay, we are back where we were. did not actually kill anything on the way back up, because you don't have to kill like any of the enemies in this game, really. It's you just kill them because they're there, but you honestly just don't have to. This is actually where we need to end up finishing here. So I want to just quickly see, is there any item stuff up here? The answer is no. Alright. So with that said, we are going to see what is in the cauldron bit here. That was a completely meaningful transition, I suppose. But yeah, I figured it would be you. I was hoping it'd be Auron, but no, straight in with Utsuho. Uh-huh. Wait, what? Who told you? Yeah, what? Wasn't Satori? Yeah, well, no, Satori actually wants us to work together. The Green Lady! Green Lady? Yeah, that was who I was thinking. Sanae, huh? No, probably not. Actually, no, of course they do, because, yeah. So what does Sanae have against Remilia? Come and fight me. Yeah, sure, whatever. Uh-huh. Yeah. Alright, so, Utsuho. What have you got for us, apart from a freaking awesome music, of course, as you do. Wow! Okay, yeah, you use a projectile at the end of your attack there. That is good to know. Also, she does the foot stomp from 12.3, so... So that's a basic melee, not too difficult to deal with. Of course, she hits pretty hard, and she has the uncontrollable dive from... Whoa! Hello! That was a bit more scary. Okay, significantly more powerful there than I'd expected. And of course she has spell cards. This is pulling me in gravity-wise, so that's fine. That's pretty easy to deal with. Yeah, that is powerful though, if you get caught in the middle of that. But I can just like outrange her if I really want, though, which is fine. Whoa, and that's pushing me away when she does that. So, yeah, Utsuho really hurts. Okay, we might actually die to Utsuho here because she is pretty freaking strong, and of course you can't jump over those attacks. So. You do have to be careful about that. You can, of course, vampire spin through a lot of stuff if you want, but you have to be careful when you use it. And what is this one going to be? This is... Okay, these are aimed at me, which is fine. Not too difficult to deal with. This is significantly more... difficult if you don't set it up right, though. Once you've got it going, it's fine, but this is still gonna hit. Okay, that's fine. It hits a lot of damage off of that, and this is the one that pulls me in, so I think we're still okay. There's one more heal I can take in the corner here, and yeah, once you know that this attack is coming, it's really not that bad. Just like a lot of attacks in this game, actually! Stop spamming the charge against me, damn it! Ow! Okay, that's fine. We can win from... Well, we can't win from that, but... Oh, God! I am actually gonna get wrecked, because I took, like, four hits in really, really quick succession there. Maybe? Or can I pull this out? No! I can't pull it out, because apparently I didn't get my combo to connect properly. Ah, I was right there as well. That's annoying. Whatever. Looks like we've seen pretty much everything for this fight now, so... Yeah, even just face tanking a lot of stuff there, that's not really as bad as I thought it would be.